Welcome back to the workshop. What we're going to do is something I've always been looking forward to do. The model community has given me so much back in enjoyment and fun and great support that I'm going to start putting out support to the small guys as well as the big guys, but the small guys who are making hobby products for all of us to enjoy but don't have those big marketing dollars to put it in front of thousands of people's faces. I do not charge to review these products. I do not accept fees. I do not accept anything except the product. So if you make a cool product and you want to see it on the show, if you send me copies of it, contact me through the contact email on YouTube. That is only allowed to be used for business emails. Let me know what your product is, as I think it's something that's useful to the hobby market. If you send me some samples, we'll get them on the show today. The very first episode of this is from Design Resource Engineering. Todd got a hold of me and says he builds hobby tool stands. Now, you saw me build some from Artie Station. Those were very great. Well, these are made in the USA, designed in the USA by Todd, and he builds them himself and ships them out to hobby users. This one here is the 12-inch hobby tool stand. It's got three bins and a tray across the top for storing small parts. It comes with everything you're going to see on camera. The total height from top to bottom is 13 inches. It's 12 inches wide. You can see right there. It is, let's see, what are the dimensions on this thing? 4.5 inches deep, 3 1/8 inch this way. You can see the nice back, well built with cabinet grade plywood and button head screws, metal parts and all wood. It's got numerous angled parts holders for sandpaper. It's got container holders. It's got hook holders for your hobby clippers and your cutters. These holes up here, according to the spec sheet, are 1/4 inch and 3/8 inch holes, and the rest are 1/2 inch holes. And then all these slots down here are a few inches deep. They're 1/2 inch from front to back for things like sanding sticks, sandpaper. The area down here is 1 1/3 inches wide and 4 inches tall for holding glue bottles and storage containers and water cups for your decals. It's an excellent, excellent tool holder. I'm going to link down in the description to pick it up, but that's not it. That's not the only thing that Todd has designed for us from Design Resource Engineering. Let me get this off the desk because we got something even cooler coming out here. Check this thing out. Massive. All right, this is the 12-inch hobby tool case. It's got a removable lid. My favorite part about this removable lid, we've got all four cabinet grade handles and clasps on this thing. We got a big metal handle up here. You take it off, you got this cool lid, right? This you hold out like a shield when you come into the house with a new kit. And the wife is like, we just spent $400 on a model ship. And you're like, back, Shiva. And then you can get out the jewelry that you bought her to make her happy at the same time. So, not screwing around. We've got cabinet grade plywood. Check this out. It's got full width hinges, not little cheap hinges on the side. All steel, all button heads screwed together. Look at this thing. It opens up in any angle. This is for a lot of you that have to store your model tools and equipment. You got to put it away. You got to keep it away from the kids and the cats and the dogs because you build on the dining room table and you got to be able to store everything, and you can do it in this 12-inch hobby tool case. So we got the removable lid and shield, as I'll call it, to keep the evil people at bay, to get them backed away from your cool stuff. I like it like this, kind of cool with its own little wings, and then you can work right here in front of it. It's pretty neat. So the descriptions on this one, we've got numerous plastic bins in their large storage containers on top, and you can remove these and put whatever else you'd like to put on it. We've got all kinds of storage, just like the other hobby tool case. This is pretty much a copy of the first one we saw. We've got little different size holes up here, all angled out. We've got, what size holes does it say? We've got 9/16 1/2 inch holes for storing knives, paint brushes, small tubes of glue. Over here, we've got storage for screwdrivers, files, calipers. We've got all different kinds of hobby square. It sticks through here and hangs on this base. This one over here, 3/16 inch holes for drill bits, all canted out. We've got 3-inch storage area here. for all different kinds of liquids containers and anything else you could think of. Over here we can hang our tools again. We've got the half inch wide slots for our sandpaper and our sanding sticks. And on this side, we've got the plastic bin on top. We've got the larger storage on bottom, and we've got the multi-size holes. We've got 1/4 inch, 3/8 inch, 1/2 inch holes, and interchangeable tool holders to go back and forth between the two, all for your brushes, knives, and other storage. So these things are pretty amazing. He sent over both of these items, and they're absolutely outstanding built. That's why I'm kind of getting a little rough with them, because you can't break them. They're American made by a new hobby tool designer, and I think they're just great, and I'm happy to get them on the show, give them some attention that he wouldn't be able to get elsewhere, because everybody else in the hobby wants to charge you a fortune to advertise. I don't charge anything, just send me an example. We'll get it on the show for you. I will link at the bottom. Thanks a million to Todd for sending these. They can't be cheap to build, and they can't be cheap to send to the show. And he enjoys the show like you guys do. And he wanted to get these over to me and say, hey man, would you take a look at them? Tell me what you think. And if I could work with one hand while holding a camera, we'll get it all across here. You can see the back is all well done. And I said, yeah, man, go ahead, send me your stuff. We'll get it on the show. And I make the same offer to all of you. If you're a hobby material designer and you want to send things over to the show, I'm not going to charge you a dime. Just send me the product. Tell me what you want to tell me about it. We'll get it on the show and start helping the little guys in the model hobby. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see you all at the next review.